Okay, folks, you all put your phones on silent for us, please. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, can I give you a very warm welcome to Windsor Park tonight for the club's annual remembrance service. It's good to see so many here tonight. Also, a big welcome to our friends from the Royal British Legion who are regular visitors here to Windsor Park, and also to our piper, Francis Strain, and to everyone else, all our vice presidents, former players and supporters who've come here tonight. It just seems like a short time ago we were all standing in Northern France to unveil the club's new memorial out in Bertrandcourt. What a proud moment that was for everyone at the club. But equally important that we also have remembrance back here in Belfast at Windsor Park, where the players played so loyally for Linfield Football Club. Just before I hand over to Johnny to start tonight's service, just want to read a short letter. The club wrote to the new Prince of Wales, just to let him know he's a huge football fan, as you all know, and is involved with English FA, but also someone who is hugely involved in a number of remembrance projects, and he has since replied to the club. Dear Mr. Chairman, thank you for your letter of the 7th of October to the Prince of Wales in connection with your new war memorial to the fallen in Bertrandcourt in Northern France. His Royal Highness was grateful to you for bringing Linfield Football Club's moving project to his attention. He was heartened to learn of the relationship you have built with this local community, not just with this new project, but also through the sports and education work you're doing with young people. It was kind of you to take the trouble to write as you did. The Prince of Wales has asked me to send you his warmest thanks and best wishes to you and everyone at Linfield Football Club, and that's from Kensington Palace. So a nice recognition from the Royal Family. So, Johnny.
Just reiterate what Roy said. It's just a short time ago we were all together in France. We laughed. We had great humour, but most of all, we give our fallen love's last gift, which was remembrance. I would like to call on club legend Alan Fraser, who's going to read a poem out, and it's entitled Legend.
Names are craved in Portland Stone. These boys were friends of mine. We joined the old brigade together as I looked back down through time. We prayed to God above us just to help us through that hell. Their names shall liveth forever more as we remember the boys who fell. The year was 1916 in a place called Thiefel Wood. With the Royal Irish Rifles together we all stood, just waiting on the orders. And into no man's land, we would go and face a barrage of machine gun fire that came from German foe. It was once a quiet French village, but now this place, it looked like hell, as the shells rained down upon us, and the gas gave a deadly smell. For king and for country, through our blood, sweat, tears and pain, as they climbed out of the trenches, God bless, out boys, they fell like rain. As I lay there in a shell hole, I could only think of all my friends. As those poor boys went into battle, many knew their lives would end. Some shouted, "No surrender," and some just said a simple prayer. As they walked across into no man's land, death was waiting in the air. No, it's a glorious dead that we call them as. We remember them with pride, those brave young lads in Flanders fields, who fought for us and died. Now the peace was so hard fought, for in the winter mud and the rain, as it climbed out of the trenches, God bless our boys, they fell like rain.
I would like to call on our club chaplain, Paul Reid, for the Bible reading.
Christianity is a faith system that requires holding both the beauty and the ugliness of humanity together. So there's a tragedy and a beauty in what we're capable of. Men are capable of some of the greatest evils, and yet at the same time, acts of great love and sacrifice, because they're made in the image of God. And Christianity requires us to hold these tensions together and to accept them or lament them. We hold this tension by recognising it is within this story that we find both beauty and hope. We find beauty in the image of God we've been gifted, and in our capacity to love and be righteous. But we find hope in our sin and failures, because they point us to the love of God and to the cross of Jesus Christ. All of these young men would have had a copy of John's Gospel, every one of them. And before they went into battle, they would have had a pre-service going over the top. And many chaplains would have read these words from Scripture. It's from Luke's Gospel, chapter 23. One of the criminals who hung there hurled insults at him. "Aren't you the Messiah? Save yourself and us." But the other criminal rebuked him. "Don't you fear God," he said, "since you're under the same sentence. We're punished justly, for we're getting what our deeds deserve. But this man has done nothing wrong." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." As these young men faced death, I believe, and certainly when you read their letters home that they wrote the night before they went into battle, many of them called out to God and actually said the same words, "Remember me." Because they viewed the upcoming battle and they considered the possible outcome. They needed something, the reassurance that in the event of their death, they were right with God. And like that thief on the cross who also faced death, they said, "Remember me." And in return, Jesus promised what he promised to the dying thief on the cross, eternal life. What an assurance some of those young men had. And these words and the promises are still powerful today. And like the thief on the cross and many who gave their lives in defense of their country, who said those simple words, "Remember me," we also can have that same promise given to us if we say the same words, "Remember me."
As the gaffer gave his team talk at Windsor Park one day, his players, they sat and listened to all that he had to say. But standing in the corner, these young lads came to light, some dressed in ghostly uniforms. They were an awesome sight. Now the gaffer, he was speechless as this young lad turned and said, "Sir, we once played for Linfield, but now we are Linfield's glorious dead. We are the spirits from the trenches, and back to Windsor Park we came. We played in many finals here, and we won immortal fame. We were part of that famous charge on the 1st of July morn, and as we rose up from the trenches, we were cut down like corn. Officers and privates fell in that great charge of fame. They lie there side by side now. Their rank is just the same. Gaffer, we lost so many players. Some were my boyhood chums. Young lads cut down by shrapnel, and some by a sniper's gun. In the bloody fields of Flanders, where many brave young Linfield players fell, as they moved up towards the frontline trenches, it was like entering the gates of hell. They were taken in their early youth, away from the team that they loved. They served their king and country. Now, they serve their king above. From the city boy in the shipyards to the country boy in his plough, how they all once played for Linfield, and they sleep in heaven now. Rifleman Walker said to the manager, "Sir, please don't be afraid, for you will always have behind you the boys of Linfield's old brigade. And as the piper leads you out at Windsor, hold your head up high with pride, for they'll be standing there beside you, all those Linfield boys who died." but the hardest part has came and gone. That's when these heroes returned home and missing from their marching ranks, our dear beloved sons. And when you stand at Windsor and you see the pit so green, please just remember them and think what might have been. Though in death, still loyal and true, just a glimpse of their ghosts in red, white and blue. Audacious, fortuna, juvat, fortune favours the brave. Ladies and gentlemen, let's remember our glorious dead. they shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun, and in the morning, we will remember them.
We will remember them.
Rifleman Arthur James, Royal Irish Rifles, Boer War, 1900. Corporal William James Creevery, Manchester Regiment, killed in action, 1916. Rifleman J. Edmondson, Royal Irish Rifles, killed in action, 1918. Sergeant Patrick Hagan, Royal Scots, killed in action, 1916. Lance Corporal James Forbes, Gordon Highlanders, killed in action, 1918. Captain George Gibson, Royal Irish Rifles, killed in action, 1918. Second Lieutenant Wesley Maltzade, Royal Irish Rifles, killed in action, 1916. Rifleman Wesley Hall, Royal Irish Rifles, killed in action, 1915. Private Leslie Houston, Royal Enniskillen Fusiliers, killed in action, 1914. Private T.W. King, Gloucester Regiment, killed in action, 1917. Lance Corporal Isaac McConnell, Royal Engineers, killed in action, 1917. Sergeant Richard Moore, Royal Irish Rifles, died of illness, 1918. Private E. Turner, killed in action, 1917. Rifleman James Walker, Royal Irish Rifles, killed in action, 1916. Rifleman David Drennan, Royal Irish Rifles, killed in action, 1916. Private A. McNeil, Royal Irish Fusiliers, killed in action, 1916. Our World War II casualties. Sergeant Frederick Fisher, Royal Air Force Volunteer Reserve, killed in action, 1944. Lieutenant John Malcolmson Gibson, Light Ack Regiment, killed in action, 1942. Bombardier Archibald Jackson Grant, Royal Artillery, killed in action, 1942. And God was with them as they passed over, and the trumpets in heaven sounded for them on the other side. Farewell, the light of our homes, our dear young sons, your duty nobly done. They rest now in eternal sleep. Precious memories of them we will always keep. Now tranquil they sleep, their nightly virtue proved. Their names are now hallowed in the football club that they loved. God bless them all.
Let's pray. Father, we are grateful for the memory of these young men and women who fell in the Boer War, the Great War, the Second War, and all conflicts in between and since. We We thank you for their memory. We thank you, Father, for their sacrifice. We thank you, Father, for their selflessness. We thank you, Father, in the face of mortal danger, they went and defended their country. We thank you, Father, for the word of God that they would have heard before they went over the top. We thank you, Father, for the young men who put their trust in you and received assurance and comfort as they heard those words. Remember me. Remember me. And may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen.
I just thank you all for attending this evening. It's been a very, again, poignant service. It's been a memorable year for the club and what we've done, I think, what we've achieved. Hopefully we have done them proud. Can I ask you all at the end, after we've had the national anthem, please stay for a cup of tea or coffee. You're more than welcome. Thank you.